Well, we had a great focus today on tag team wrestling. I'd certainly be remiss not to have one of the great masters of tag team wrestling of the Freebirds, Michael Hayes, here. The return of the Rock and Roll Express, great showing by the Z-Man and Flying Brian. The competition is getting keener.
Well, it's always been keen here, and it gets keener, and the 90s is going to be no different. But I want to make one thing perfectly clear. There's a lot of wrestlers coming out here and saying they're going to do this, they're going to do that, and the 90s is going to be their decade. But there's not one that came out here in 1980 like the Freebirds, made a statement, put professional wrestling tag team specifically on its ear, and followed through, did they?
True.
Now I'm going to tell you once again, the Freebirds are going to fly high again in the 90s. And rock and roll, like they say, there ain't nothing like solid gold, and rock and roll's forever. Not if you come down a bad street. And Pillman, Frying Brian, you and the Z-Man, buddy, we got a problem. We got a big problem. Because you got two real pretty faces, like they say it belongs in Hollywood. But brother, I'm going to rearrange them faces. Jimmy Jam's going to rearrange them faces. And don't ever forget that there's not just two, there's four Freebirds.
What do you mean by that? Interesting comment from Michael Hayes. There are three Samoans as well. Let's go up to Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, in your next event, introducing first from Naples, Italy, at 260 pounds, the Italian Stallion. And his partner from Paradise City at 265 pounds, Brody Chase. Introducing their opponents, making their way into the ring area. The Big Kahuna, Sir Oliver Humperdinck, presents from the island of Samoa, Samu and Fatu, the Samoan SWAT team, the SST.
And they are joined also by the Samoan Savage. Kevin Sullivan, do you have any indication what Michael Hayes meant by saying there are four Freebirds?
I was going to ask you the same thing. I know there's Jimmy, and I know there's Michael, and I know there's Buddy, and I know there's Terry, but I don't know where Buddy and Terry are.
Interesting comment. I'd like to keep our eye on that situation. Could be a most interesting development. As I said, there are three Samoans. How could you miss them?
And they're three of the baddest apples in the world. These guys, I really like them, Jimmy. First of all, they give no quarter and they ask no quarter. They go out and they try to do one thing, and that's hurt people. And that's the name of the game in professional wrestling. There's some kind of ritual that they do. I don't know anything about it.
Are they warding off bad spirits or good spirits? Probably those guys. Or is it a good luck thing? Or I don't know. What
I think they're bucking up to see who's going to pay for the bar bill tonight.
Wow. A lot of Kahlua, or what do they drink? I don't know. Coconut milk. Spike, probably. Knowing Sir Oliver, the kahuna there. All right, it's going to be Samu starting out against the Italian Stallion. Italian Stallion and Brody Chase here on World Championship Wrestling. Still to come, Arn Anderson and Steen together to take on the Galaxians. We're going to hear from Woman as well, and I'll be talking to all four horsemen before we go off the air. Exchange of wrist locks there by the Stallion and Samu, but Samu gets the better of him. Great move, rolling right over. 300-pounder with that kind of agility is scary.
It certainly is, Jim. I've never seen a guy that big do that before. Have you?
Certainly have not. Great agility. Great agility. Stallion sends him for the ride. Here the ropes crack. Stallion trying to go up there. It was anticipated by Samu, and he kicked him right in the face.
This is what I talked to you about before. They like to hurt people, and they like to beat them up real good. Brody Chase, I think he's doing nothing but aggravating this big guy.
Look at that move right into an arm bar. Great move there. Great adjustment. Well, nothing fancy about that.
Jim, we're seeing something different, though, this week. I haven't seen the Samoans do this much wrestling. I don't know if it's the Great Kahuna that's put them to be wrestling like this, or the three of them. There he is. What a face.
Foster Grant would love that guy. Oh, what a clothesline right at the top rope. Man, these guys are big and savage. I've talked about their flexibility, their ability to kick a man, a tall man, right in the face. It's really been amazing. And look at this. The Savage out there at Humperdinck, or the Kahuna's insistence. interjecting himself there on a helpless Brody Chase, and he's thrown back into the Wolves. Chase is out of it.
He's on his feet.
Yeah.
He's on his feet. The referee needs to stop the match.
He does. He does need to stop it.
He needs to stop the match because this guy is going to get hurt bad. He's going to get hurt permanently, and they're going to do it right now. They're going to teach this guy a lesson. Never get in the ring with them ever.
Italian Stallion being restrained, putting outside, but the damage has been done. Brody Chase is a hurt man. Let's keep our eye on him. He is an injured man. He has been brutalized and beaten by the three Samoans here in this contest. As Kevin Sullivan said, perhaps referee Nick Patrick should use some discretionary officiating and stop this one. I'm not saying the official is not doing a good job.
He's doing an excellent job, Jim.
As always, but you've got to look and say, look at the guy's eyes and say, I think he's had enough. He's helpless. He can't even fight back. The Samoans obviously sense that, Kevin, but they have not shown any mercy at all.
And that's what I like about them. They show no mercy at all, and they're going to beat him up to the floor. Now, this guy is going to have to be carried out on a stretcher, a blotter, or a pickup truck and laid in the back. This guy needs to go home, and this guy needs to get into early retirement. Watch this one. I've seen this one.
Fall away slam. Got him on his shoulders. Fell away with him. And there is a tag. And big fought, too. Well over 300 pounds up top.
This
move right here. Oh, puts him away. There's no way. Brody Chase, we're going to need medical attention on this one. Here's Rhubarb in the word.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the event, Samu and Fatu, the Samoan SWAT team.
I've said it many times, the Samoans borderline out of control. The Stallion trying to defend his fallen partner there. But look at the Samoans take over again on Brody Chase. They throw him for the ride, and they double clothesline him. Stallion's trying to fight, but there's just too many of them. And now the Stallion's going to get some of the same punishment dished out to Brody Chase. Wow, what action. These big monsters are something.
You think they're trying to send a message to the Road Warriors, the Skyscrapers, Doom, or whoever it may be? These guys, whether it's the Samoan Savage in a single.
And fans will be back. Don't go away. We'll hear from Woman and see Anderson and Sting after this.